Welcome back, everyone, to Welstopia. I have finished with the banners on the interior here, so therefore you can now see them going up all the way. Though I still haven't quite finished with the supports that I am building up here. So you can see the ones that I built in the previous episode. But I still need a few more, or at least I think I need a few more of these. I went through a lot of trouble to collect this wood, so there better be a few more left. Ah, here we go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remind myself where I put everything, and then we are going to finish this up. And after that, we can get to the new things I want to do for this episode. I am back here in the tunnel to add another spruce sapling. And you say, what is that all about? And that's because I kept on running out of oak. You say, well, why is that a spruceable infringement? Because I've been waiting and waiting and waiting for the saplings to grow, and then doing other stuff, coming back, waiting and waiting and waiting. And it wasn't until after the last cut where I finally realized I've got tons of bones and chests. I've got bones all over the place. There's something called bone meal in this game, which helps things grow faster. Well, it's not exactly perfect in getting trees to start growing, but it is faster than just waiting and waiting and waiting. So yes, that's the reason why I added a spruce there. So now let's go back up top and get the last of those oak pieces on there. This is as far as I can go using the logs as my primary support, because after this point all I have is this slab going all the way around. Plank, I mean. We have this little... No, it's a slab. I always get those two confused. So we have this slab going all around, lower half slab, so therefore I cannot place anything to look like a support without it looking off. Now, one possibility I'm thinking of is perhaps putting a border of stone around here and sort of make it look like it's being held up by that, because what happens if I do this, 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 and this? Ooh, and a so happens, oh yeah, that's on the edge, and on the edge we have the, yeah, I think what I'll do is I'll do this, and this will look like it's some sort of support going around. And it is nice that on the edges you won't even be able to see the stone on top, because the we have that little platform for the torso. So I think that's what I'm going to do for this section, or at least up to... We'll see how far I go with it. And make sure I don't pop that out too often. Plop this here, and then add a few more stairs, and go around, and at least the exterior will hopefully look halfway decent. And of course, this blends in so beautifully that you don't know it's there. And if you don't know it's there, why bother? Well, at least when you're down here, you do see it. And you do see a few shadows here and there. So, down in this section, it's not a total loss. I decided to go all the way down until we hit the end here where it's supported by the other means. And this goes around. I decided to keep the stuff here that's invisible just in case somebody decided to sneak in here to see is it really there. So that was more to keep believability rather than trying to make it stand out or anything like that. So now, I suppose I need to do the other thing on the inside. But can I get away with it here? Nope, I cannot. So, that's out. I have to think about a way to take care of that. But it looks like that's not going to happen. Now, I still haven't come up with a good solution for lighting here, so I think for the rest of this episode, I'm going to head down and take care of that tunnel that we pretty much abandoned quite a while back. And let's see how well I can fly in the rain. Whoops. Well, I guess I've done worse. So let's see about this tunnel and what we should do with it. Now, I will have to fill this thing in near that, or at least close it out. I think I've got torches here so that nothing will spawn inside it. I was trying to look for a place where something was spawning. I eventually found it, I believe, down here. Yeah, because I found that there was a tunnel system down here, and I went in and shut the monsters up. So I think it's time to close these off as I turn this into a proper tunnel. And the first thing I'm going to do is to get rid of this tree. Good. Now, what kind of pattern do I want for this tunnel? And that's where this little box comes into play. And in here, I have, right, some more banners. But most importantly, I have some spruce wood, some andesite, and some granite. And that's what I am going to be using for this particular tunnel. The andesite will be the main part of the background for the tunnel. The spruce is going to be the support, and I'm going to have the granite alternating with the andesite as I go through here. So I figure we could I don't know why I insist on grabbing every single sapling, but alright, I'll just move. No, never mind. So therefore, the question is where I want to put this. Now, I figure that we're going to want the wood to be at the level right here. So, therefore, we are going to have to recess everything else back. So, we are going to have to clear out the sides to here. And preferably not going down or anything like that. For now, just fill that in there. So let me clear this out, and I'll be back. And here is the tunnel. One little problem I've got is that this is now open to the air. Most likely what I'm going to do is I'm going to first work on the tunnel and then do a little landscaping on that side on the outside afterwards to hide that little breach. Now, over here, we have two sides with our usual sandstone and nether brick. Now, my original plan here was to leave this with stone, but now, of course, it would be more fitting considering the construction materials of the road, if we go far enough back, that I should be using cobble instead for this. And so, my next step then is to replace all of this with cobble. Or better yet, perhaps I should be using cobble stairs for this section, because that's what I have going along the road. Let's have a little consistency here. Now let's worry about these walls. We will begin here with our design for our entrance. Therefore, we'll skip that and put andesite here. And what we'll do is we'll put andesite at every other location, like this. And we'll do that for both ends. With the andesite done, then we'll begin with the granite, and we'll be putting the granite into every other one of these holes. Now I am going to be needing a filler behind all of this. Not behind all of this, but behind the next stage, so I may use either andesite or granite. Actually, maybe cobble would be a good thing to use as the filler in the back. Oh, oops, almost made a major mistake there. And yeah, actually, I think this will work out quite well, because then I could be putting the closer there, and right. Good. So let me actually getting the granite here won't be as tough as for the final section on the sides. I will be putting some cobble here as filler, and then there you go. And then I'll be placing spruce in front of it. So I'll be alternating it that way. Now I was wondering what to do about the little trouble that we've got these stairs here. And of course you can see that the spruce doesn't quite all go all the way down through there. Now I was thinking that maybe I could just have the spruce go all the way down in there, therefore this pattern goes only for three. But on here I'm thinking that we have this little culvert here, so that if we do actually have to drain anything along here, then it'll just go under here. But then it's no, that's not as good as for support. So I am gonna drop that idea and just put it down like this, so therefore these little drainage areas are just going to have to be local rather than going all the way through. And since there won't be as much to drain on the interior as there would be on the exterior, I think that should be fine. Oh, let's get that right, and that way we can now do this the right way, getting rid of the piece of cobble there, and then no, we want that done right. Good, good. And good, like that. So I'll do this for the rest. Now we have to worry about the ceiling. And on the ceiling right now we have mostly smooth stone and dirt, since I definitely don't want dirt to be my block of choice. I am going to remove that and use smooth stone for this, simply because that will be the easier one to do at the moment. So let me get all this cleared out and replaced with smooth stone, actually. Yeah. Now, since these logs are ostensibly here as support, we will, of course, add them up here to act as the support. That's in here, 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 and here. And preferably to do this without getting in my way. Three, and then one, two. Now, originally, I was just thinking staying smoothstone all the way across here, but as I was finishing up placing all that with, then I was thinking that maybe granite would be a good idea for this. So that we just continue the pattern that we have along on the wall. So therefore it goes like that, shadowing that. Now, one of the problems we are going to have is, of course, lighting. And what's the best thing to use for the lighting? I can't think of anything good and perfect at the moment, so I'll probably just stick some end rods there. And I'll stick end rods right here, I think would be a good location for them. And that will seem to be reasonably appropriate. And now let's get this done. Ooh, I'm just going to run out before it. Well, that is the pattern I have. So once I have that, then I think all that we have left will be the lights. Well, and of course, making sure that we don't have anything unsightly outside. There are two possible ways to handle the lighting situation. One is just to stick an end rod here. And since we have these logs at every other one, the end rods shouldn't look too out of place on the matter. I think it should give us plenty of light to keep out mobs. Of course, the alternative is to make it vertical or something like this, but if I did that, then we go on to the entire question about the sides again. So the other possibility will be glowstone. That is ugly. Yeah, I don't think that works for this build. So therefore, we will go back to the other plan. Where'd that block go? For the entrance, we will use a support system, such as what we are using out there, except instead of using wood, we are going to be using our old friend stone brick. Now, I want to start by making it like this. Oops. Actually, maybe we will leave that there, too. Good, 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 and yes. We'll do it like that. But of course, we are going to be wanting an arch in here. Because stone needs arches in order to work properly, and do we have anything that'll work for that? Let's see, do I have any none in there. Well, that should be fixable easily enough. And put this right over here. Good. And then plop that right over there to act as our middle. You know, I think I was better off I was better off just leaving it like that. Alright. Now, I'll probably have to do something above that in order to make that a little bit better. But right now, that just gives us our basic entrance over there. And we can do that for the other side also. And that will have the basic part of the tunnel done. Get that here, get that there. Good. And let's do a little chopping of dirt over here. One little place there, we want good. Oh, yeah, I don't want that standing over there. And let's see, over here, and there we have it, our entrances. Now we need to cover up the sides a little bit here, because we don't want to have all that stuff exposed. Maybe something that's not so not so sharp would also be a good idea. Especially if I want to ever climb this or anything like that. Alright, let's... like right now, in order to do this. Good. Right, not exactly expert terraforming, but... it gets the job done, and that... is how not to jump off wood. And that's our, well, yeah. I'll need to take care of the entrance and the exit, but overall, we've got quite a bit done on this. Oh, yeah. At least one more layer, though. Just to... oh, shut up. Hey, hey! You got the idea. So, that will conclude this episode. Next time I need to come up with a plan for the lighting of that lighthouse. And unless I can think of something better, I'll be back. I think one final touch-up will be to add an extra piece of cobble here with an end rod. Which means getting rid of that thing. That way we could have a bit of a greeting here. And I can get rid of these torches, because the entire reason for using all those end rods is so we won't have these torches in the middle of the street. We get rid of those and do the same thing on this end. Pop it there, pop it there. End rod. And rod, and there you go. And that is that. And that concludes today's episode. And until next time, this is Pineleaf Needles reminding you to mine responsibly.